So this is a question that has bothered me 2 times, and both times I was not able to solve it very clearly. So I had to search on Stack Exchange and see if there are any answers for this, and there was one answer, and it was like, yeah, it was as if I was just giving up on solving it and just seeing if there are any answers, like if it is even solvable in the first place. But yeah, it is solvable. And there's a very nice answer to it and a very nice method. So the method actually relies on converting the difference over here. So this negative sign, it changes that into a product or a ratio or something like that. So basically something that can be manipulated by putting natural log on it. And in that way, you can convert whatever these factorials are inside into series, and you can solve that series as integrals. So let me show you what I mean by that. So you can write this as n factorial to the power of 1 upon n, so that common, and that times n plus 1 factorial to the power of 1 upon n plus 1 upon n factorial to the power of 1 upon n minus 1. Now this thing, it's less than its arithmetic mean. So this is a geometric mean, by the way, because there are n numbers multiplied to the power of 1 upon n, and it should be less than its arithmetic mean. Its arithmetic mean will just be n into n plus 1 upon 2, because 1 plus 2 plus 3 till n upon 2, and that upon n, because the total number of numbers, that's going to be n plus 1 upon 2. It's to the order of n plus it's to the order of n basically, right? So that means if I put n over here and n over here, then this thing is actually a finite thing, and we can calculate what that is. So let's do that. First of all, just calculate what this thing is. So let's say L is the limit as n tends to infinity of n factorial to the power of 1 upon n upon n. So natural log L, that will be limit as n tends to infinity of natural log of this thing. So that's just 1 upon n natural log of n factorial minus natural log of n. So we can write that as limit as n tends to infinity of 1 upon n natural log of n factorial upon n to the power of n. And now we can write that as limit as n tends to infinity 1 upon n summation. So this is from r equal to 1 till n of r upon n, actually the natural log of that. So natural log of r upon n. That makes sense, right? So now this thing is basically an integral. So it's just the integration from, so this is Riemann sum, that's what they call it, whatever. This converts to an integral. So it's from 0 to 1, because when r is 1, this just approaches 0. When r is n, it approaches 1. And it's 0 to 1. This thing converts to dx. So it's the change in these quantities. And it's just natural log of x. Right. And how do we solve this? Well, it's like 1 into natural log of x. We'll integrate this thing and differentiate that thing. Integrating this, you just get x. That times natural log x. Minus, when you differentiate this, it just becomes 1, and this is x, sorry, this is 1 upon x, and that is x, so it becomes 1, and integration of 1 from 0 to 1, that's just 1, like that. Cool. And it goes from 0 to 1. When you put 1 over here, natural log of 1 is 0, so it goes away anyway. But when you put 0, it becomes an indeterminate form. And how would you get that done if it's not actually something that you can directly calculate? So you need to put another limit over here. So limit as x tends to 0 of x natural log x, which is basically natural log x upon 1 upon x. And then if you differentiate the numerator and the denominator of this thing, it would just be 1 upon x upon negative 1 upon x squared, right? The limit as x tends to 0 of this thing, which is 0, right? So make that go up, and this will just be x, and it becomes 0. That means this complete thing is just not there, right? So it's just negative 1. And natural log L being negative 1, that means L is e power negative 1. So that's cool. Now you know what this actually is. It's just e power negative 1. So you can write this as e power negative 1. And this would just be n plus 1 factorial to the power of 1 upon n plus 1 upon n factorial to the power of 1 upon n minus 1, that times n. Cool. Now look at this thing. This is already a ratio that we can kind of try to manipulate and stuff. But the thing is, even if you manipulate this, you won't actually be able to do anything because there's this minus 1 in front of it. So if I just had this ratio, nothing else, right, then it would work. And the way I'm gonna do it is I'm gonna divide this by the natural log of this same thing. So I'm gonna put it in brackets and this same bracket, and that times natural log. Okay, so this bracket, it contains the same thing as this, right? Notice that this actually approaches 1, so natural log of something approaching 1, that's 0. So this is like a 0 by 0 format. And if you know what I'm talking about, then this thing is actually going to approach 1. Why is that? Because you can say like, okay, this bracket, it's just 1 plus x, where x approaches 0. Then this thing, it's 1 plus x minus 1. So it's x upon natural log of 1 plus x. That's what this actual thing is. And x upon natural log of 1 plus x as x approaches 0, that is 1. So this thing approaches 1. Cool. Okay, so the remaining stuff, that's just n natural log of n plus 1 factorial to the power of 1 upon n plus 1 upon n factorial to the power of 1 upon n plus. And now we are free to do anything that we want, because it's just the ratio. There's nothing in front of it. There's no difference. There's nothing. So now how would we do this? So we can write n plus 1 factorial, that as n plus 1 times n factorial, so that we can try to change the n factorial to something that we can use, right? So, or maybe like cancel it if it gets cancelled. So putting this over here, it's just n plus 1 to the power of 1 upon n plus 1 n factorial to the power of 1 upon n plus 1 minus 1 upon n, because of this thing, right? And that's just n plus 1 to the power of 1 upon n plus 1 upon n factorial to the power of 1 upon n into n plus 1, right? To the subtraction, it becomes this thing, which is n plus 1 upon n factorial to the power of, well, this is to the power of 1 upon n, all of that to the power of 1 upon n plus 1, right? And all of this is going to be inside another natural log. So what will happen is basically this n plus 1, it can come on the front, right? Actually, it should be like all of that to the power. Yeah, but you get what I'm saying, right? Right. And now it's just this thing, basically 1 upon n right there. It comes on the front, but then there's this n waiting right front of, right, on the front, and that means it cancels completely. And now we're just left with this limit inside the natural log. Do we know what this limit is? Actually, we do, because n plus 1 is to the order of n. And n upon n factorial to the power of 1 upon n, look, it's just the reciprocal of this thing. So that's going to be basically e, right? This quantity is just e, so it's natural log of e right there. That's going to be 1. So all of this is just not there. It's just 1. So e power negative 1, that is the limit. Cool. So I'll see you guys in the next video.